Hello, I'm Marc Desgroseilliers from Technical Support here at Pix4D, and today I will talk to you about orthofacades. What do we mean by orthofacade? Well, it's an ortho-rectified image of the facade of a building or any other object in your project which is more or less planar. This is a concept which is going to be familiar to you if you know what an orthomosaic is. If you don't know what an orthomosaic is, then I encourage you to have a look at one of our other videos where we talk about the mosaic editor. So basically, your orthomosaic is going to be generated always from the top down. Whereas the orthofacade, it gives you the possibility to change this orientation, and so to generate the orthomosaic of the facade of a building, for example. You're going to be able to change the orientation by inserting an orthoplane object in your project. When you insert the orthoplane, you should make sure that the green arrow is always pointing towards the facade of the building, as in the image that you see here. You can also adjust the size of the orthoplane by adjusting the red, blue, and green balls for the different directions. One tool that we have in the software to improve the output and to improve the orthofacade is the annotation tool. This will allow you to remove some background from your orthofacade. So let me give you an example. Let's say your project is a church and you want to do a facade of the front of the church. So you've got the main body and then you have a bell tower at the top. And next to the bell tower, you've got some region which is not the facade of the building, which you would want to remove from your orthofacade. How would you do this? Well, first, you have to make sure that step one and step two have been processed. And then you would select an image where you can see this background that you want to remove from your orthofacade. Then you can use the annotation tool with the mask option and you can mark the background in this image. You can do this with several images to make sure that all the background that you want to remove has been annotated, and then you can generate the orthofacade to get it without this background that you want removed. Let's see in the software, step by step, how to get this output and how to use the annotation tool. Here I am in the project. This is the densified point cloud. So I'm going to start by inserting an orthoplane object. I just drop it a little bit randomly in my project because what I like to do is I like to align it to the surface. So I'm going to draw a new surface object. I'm going to draw it on the side of the building that I want to capture. So this one here. Draw my surface. Great. And now I can go back to the orthoplane and align it to the surface. And you see, now it's in the wrong direction, so I can just flip it. There you go. And now I can maybe move it around a little bit. There you go. So now my orthoplane is on my facade. And I would be able to generate the side of the orthomosaic for the side of the building. Let me show you now how to use the annotate tool. So let me say that in this region here, I would like to remove it from the orthofacade. So I'm going to click here, and now it's going to show all the images that point to this feature. Going to find, let me zoom out a little bit and find an image that works well where I can see the side of the building quite well. So let's see this one. And you can see here, I can see this region that I want to remove. So I'm going to use annotate. It needs to segment it. Once it's ready, I can start clicking on the region that I want to remove. So you see I have to click several times because what the software does is that it breaks up the image into subregions and I have to select the subregions that I want to annotate out of my orthofacade. So, something like this requires a little bit of care. And here. So now I'm satisfied. I'm going to mask it. I click apply. And now I can go back to my orthoplane here, and I adjust the side so that I can see this part like this. And now I'm ready to go. I can generate the orthomosaic. And now it's running. I want to give you a few more tips to make sure that you get good results with this tool. The first and maybe most important thing to consider is that you want to have good imagery of the side of the building that you want to capture. For example, if you only have nadir images, then the side of the building is not going to appear in many images, and so there won't be many points generated. If you want to capture this side of the building and you know that you will want to produce an orthofacade, we really recommend to take some oblique imagery and to make sure that you've got good overlap and many images of the side of the building and not just from above. In your project, you can check this by looking at the side of the building and making sure that you have enough points and that you have enough images pointing towards the side of the building. We already mentioned that the green arrow should be pointing towards the side of the building that you want to capture, but it's also important for the orthoplane to be parallel to the side of the building. And finally, to remove background, we remind you there's this annotation tool that you've seen in the software just previously. That's all I wanted to say about orthofacades and their generation. I hope you found this helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.